Hello. In this video, I want to talk about an issue with an older MacBook. This is a mid-2012 MacBook Pro, and I've heard other MacBooks have had this issue too. But my touchpad, we're looking at the bottom here, my touchpad, when you pushed on it, wouldn't click anymore. It progressively got worse. You could kind of click on it, and then it got to a point where it wouldn't click at all. I took it apart, and to take it apart, you take all these screws out. And then you can take the back off. And I found out the battery had been bulging. And when it bulged, it put pressure on the trackpad. So in this video, I want to kind of go over what I did to remedy, what I'm doing to remedy the issue. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be installing a battery. I ordered this on Amazon. I'll put a link in the description. And if you like this video and it helps you, if you use my link, it'll help me out a little bit and it won't cost you a thing. And with my Amazon affiliate account. So I bought this on Amazon. It comes with two screwdrivers. It comes with the Phillips to open the case. And it comes with the tri-wing screwdriver. And I did take the battery out. I put it back in for this video just temporarily. But I took the video out and put it back together so I could use it, and it ran fine without the battery in there. I don't know if that's good long term or not, but this is the new battery here. Take that out. That's all that's in the package. So to get the battery out, once you get the back off, you have two tri-wing screws. There's one here. It's a small one. There. And then there's one over here, and that's a longer one. And then you pop the battery connector off the motherboard, and there's a little tape tab here, and you lift it up and slide it out. And there's these kind of lock into these aluminum pieces here. And looking at this, I don't know if this will show up on camera. Looks like it might a little bit. Let me take the plastic off of this one. But this is bulged quite a bit here. You can see the one on the right's bulged. You can see on the bottom how it's flat on the left and bulged on the right. And this is kind of poofy here. And this is flat. So, looks like there's more plastic here I need to take off. So that's the replacement battery. Looks identical. It's got the little tab to help you insert it. It's got the mounting brackets there. This one has the warning, do not remove battery. I guess I'm doing that right now. So if you replace your battery, make sure you dispose of your old battery properly. I'm going to take it to a battery center, probably Interstate Battery or something. They usually take batteries free. So I'll put that in here. Line up the holes, and then I can insert the tri-wings here. I like to get both batteries, or both screws started, and then tighten them both down. Okay, and once you get the screws in, then connect up the battery. Just presses in. Okay, and then the back can be put on. And what I like to do with these screws is I like to start them all. Same thing, I like to start each one. And then tighten them all down after I get them all started. Okay, I have all the screws in, so I can flip it over now. I'll plug the power in. And I'll boot it up. Okay, I'm all logged in now. And a couple things, the trackpad now clicks. Before it wasn't clicking, it would, you could press really hard at first, but then it got to a point where you couldn't even do that. So I have this utility called Coconut Battery. Let's open it up. And this just gives you stats on the battery. It says current charge is about 3,200. Full charge is 6,057. Design capacity is 5,770. Manufacture date is October 25th of this year. Cycle count is 1. Battery status good. And the temperature. Now, the old battery, this one, didn't show any errors or anything within the system. It showed as being a good battery, but with the you know, the puffiness causing, putting pressure on the touchpad, it was causing dysfunction with the machine. So that's the replacement or the repair of the touchpad issue and the puffy battery. But if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click the like button, and thanks for watching. Bye.